a bit about the last 2 months. What have you been doing, Jen, with you? Like, keeping fit? Have you, like, managed to play squash?
Definitely not squash. Trying to keep myself fit. To be honest, like, I'm sure you will understand that how he plays pretty much the same, you know?
Yeah.
Just that, like, things are a bit disoriented in terms of, like, because there's no time and there's no... what I mean to say is that just because, like, there's no structure or discipline to anything right now, I just kind of wake up when I wake up, I do what I want, when I want to train, I train. So, just in terms of that, it's been completely different to what I'm used to. But overall, yeah, I mean, I've just been fortunate to be back home, you know, before the lockdown happened. You know, I was traveling as well. I was in Egypt, so I was lucky enough to get back in time. And that's good. Everything has been pretty okay so far.
You said, you know, about this structureless, routineless lifestyle. Is it, say, for example, pleasant difference from what you're used to? Like, I don't know, waking up at 5, training, and then catching a flight to somewhere else, and then repeating this on a week-by-week basis.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. I think, you know, initially you're just so... initially it was great because for me, I was like, hey, I'm looking forward to the break and, you know, I can, you know, just stay in one place for some time. But then obviously after a few weeks, you're so used to going somewhere, and especially because we were in the middle of our season, you know. It was very strange to not be taking a flight or not having to train the way I'm used to, or having access to, you know, the courts and all of that. But at the same time, the situation is bigger than any of us, you know, or any of our lifestyles. So it was just about making sure that we just stay safe, stay healthy, and try and keep fit in these challenging times, I guess.
Okay. Are you one of those who you wake up every morning and just see the news and get disheartened by what's happening around you, or do you like try to disassociate yourself from the wider world?
I don't think I've seen the day before 12 PM in the last two, so I don't know what morning you are talking about. I definitely read the news in terms of what's happening, how many cases, you know, where all it's serious, and you know, just to be aware. It's obviously brutal when you read stories of how everyone else is suffering, you know, trying to get back home, you know, no food. So yeah, all of that is very, very upsetting to see and read, and that's probably the only times I really get upset just when I see how difficult it is for the people in our country. So yeah, I mean, it is very disheartening, and you can just hope and pray like they're being looked after in some way, or help is given to them and all of that.
Okay. A few athletes, you know, just to establish routines, have tried to set up fitness routines on Zoom calls at a certain point of time in the day. You done something like that?
Not really. To be honest, I've just kept a very low profile. I didn't want to, talk much about training or post many pictures. I just felt like right now the country is just going through a really hard time. Absolutely fine to other people who do that. You know, that's their profession. It is mine as well. But I just chose not to. And I just wanted to just train quietly and just do my own thing.
Okay. And how exactly have you managed training? Do you have like any basic gym equipment at home? Or?
Yeah, I definitely have some gym stuff at home, and I try to train about 5 or 6 times a week. It also depended on how my body was feeling. There were days that I didn't feel like training. You know, I felt like a bit jaded, or sometimes obviously you have anxiety, you're not sure what's happening, or you know. I kind of really took it day by day. For the most part, I made sure that I trained just so that I can be in some decent level form of fitness when things resume. So I wasn't killing myself or, you know, doing things that I would do under normal situations, just enough to stay fit and be, fit, I guess.
A few athletes have said you know, apart from suffering from anxiety, if you have said about, you know, lack of motivation because of the uncertainty of what's going to happen next, have you also felt something similar, a lack of goals, for example?
I definitely have felt a lack of motivation to train, but because the discipline is there to get the work done, what really prompted me to train. But yeah, as far as motivation is there, like, there hasn't been any motivation to train, but I end up doing the work because I have to, you know, and just because I'm used to training like that. So, but it's very hard for me to get up and say, oh, let's go train, you know, like, it literally takes me 2-3 hours to get into the zone to do any form of physical work. So yeah, but I've just been training for like an hour a day, and there are days, 2-3 days in a row that I don't train, you know, like you said, because of the anxiety, because of the uncertainty. So I just take it really day by day.
Okay. Apart from that, how have you, like, you know, like, kept yourself occupied? Is it like Netflix or cooking or whatever?
Cooking is a joke. There's no way I'm cooking. That is why I'm an athlete, you know, that's all I can do right now. I haven't actually, I've not been watching much of Netflix and stuff, not a lot. So because, like I told you, I wake up pretty late, so half the day is gone. But I plan it that way, that my days are very short, you know.
Okay.
And then I kind of wake up, I hang around, I take my mom for some errands if she has to, you know, like grocery shopping or little things like that. And then I get home, and then it's like already like 4-5 in the evening. I try and train for an hour, and and then there's dinner, and then I go to sleep. It sounds, I mean, it's, to be honest, it's a good life, you know. I cannot complain, but there's just nothing really going on, you know. I try and read books. Basic stuff, like, nothing fancy or special, like.
Moving to the squash part of it, have you tried to be in touch with squash players from around the world?
Just a few who I'm close to. They're also in my same, you know, situation where they also don't know what's happening. And obviously, you know, things are uncertain because even if things do get better, there's a lot of other guidelines, right? Like whether it's with travel, whether it's with, you know, quarantining in countries that you go to. So right now, everyone's on survival mode, you know, because obviously all of us don't have a job right now, and you're just, you know, trying to manage. So I think it's you can get very overwhelmed when you start thinking too much about what's going to happen. Are you going to have a career soon enough, you know? We're all on the same boat, really, you know. Nobody knows when, where, you know. Anyway, for the next 2 months, we are out of the tour anyway, because that's like what was told to us. Like, end of July, anyway, the tour is suspended till. So, you know, things are changing every few days, you know. We're just going to wait it out till the end of July to really know what's going on.
A few, obviously, you know, expressed concern about getting back to playing and flying and stuff till a vaccine is in mass production. Are you worried about that?
Worried about what? Not having a vaccine, or
getting back to the routine without a vaccine, and you could still catch the virus like any time.
I think that's a risk that we're all going to have to be prepared for, right? For the next 1 year at least, till the vaccine comes. And I think it's just important right now to, you know, make sure that you're staying healthy, you're boosting your immunity as much as possible. Of course, the goal would be to play squash. And I think now, because all of us have been starved of doing what we love, I just have this thing that I would just love to play squash just again as a sport, you know, why I first started playing when I was a 9-year-old. You kind of have that childlike quality now to just want to be on a court, you know, and not think of traveling or touring or competing, you know. I miss that a lot, you know, just the playing part, you know, if it's just for fun. But I do believe that right now our safety and other people's safety should come first. And I feel like the government, or, you know, even our administration and federation will do whatever it takes to ensure that we can get back to the sport quickly, but with guidelines, you you know.
Yep,
and
I
just think like that is important that we all follow that. And I'm prepared to wait as long as that takes for me to get on court, at the, knowing that we're going to be much safer than probably getting on court right now.
The Ministry of Home Affairs a few days ago said that the stadiums can open without spectators. So have you considered the prospect of going back to a court?
I've not really thought about it in the sense that I do understand there's a lot of guidelines to be followed.
Mm.
I think the SAI has released a bunch of lists,
yeah.
right? A list
yeah.
where you need to have a health official, temperature checking, social distancing, all of that.
Mm.
But the thing is that squash is such a contact sport,
yeah.
you know.
Mm.
And we are not, it's, for our facility that we train at here in Chennai,
mm.
we're all not living in the complex,
yeah.
you know.
Yeah.
We all come from different places. So
mm.
all of us come from places that are potentially could be in contact with people going through the virus, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, so I think once they decide how they can go best about it is when we can understand that that is okay to go back to play there. Then once the rules are set into place, because I don't believe it's safe right now to go back to playing immediately.
Okay, you mentioned that squash is a contact sport in the first place. So, I mean, it obviously doesn't lend itself automatically to physical distancing. So, from that point of view, do you think that sport is a disadvantage as compared to, say, something like chess?
See, nobody thought this was going to ever happen.
Correct,
you know?
Correct. Yeah.
So this is not something you think of when you start playing a sport.
Yeah.
Of course, there are other sports that have more distance, like tennis and,
mm.
you know, maybe even badminton also.
Mm.
And squash isn't like that. But is it a disadvantage? I mean, it's just unfortunate that, you know, the virus is spread through such close proximity, you know.
Mm.
And, of course, squash falls into that category. Is such a high contact, less space between each other kind of sport.
Mm.
But it is what it is. So you can't, I can't say, it's not, to me, squash is not a disadvantage in any way.
Okay.
You know,
mm.
it just might take some time coming back to playing and that's okay.
Okay. Do you think there'll be some level of paranoia, for example, like when you walk onto court, would you look at your competitor and say to yourself, hang on, she could be a potential vector or something like that?
Wow, you're asking me questions that have not even crossed my mind. No, I mean, at the end of the day, right now, I'm only thinking of how it would be to just be on a squash court, you know, not really competing with anyone. But obviously, when the time does come to compete and all of that, I'm sure things would be in a much better situation.
Mm.
So I don't think, I mean, as an athlete, you're just going to want to play and, you know, do well for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So as far as someone having it or not having it, I mean, things are never going to just go back to normal immediately, you know.
Yes.
Everyone's going to live and operate in a very different way, especially with sports, moving forward.
Mm.
So like I said, the only thing you can do right now is, you know, look after yourself, just make sure you're well and healthy.
Okay. With back, you said something about, you know, just wanting to go back to the court and just feel like what you felt as a 9-year-old. So do you
yeah.
think at least for the next few months, you may see squash as something that you played because you loved and not because it is an occupation?
Yeah, I mean, for sure, you know, like, obviously I love what I do, and
yeah.
that's my biggest motivation as well.
Mm.
But obviously when you're competing back to back to back, like, you kind of sometimes I feel you can lose that little bit of passion, you know, that you had when you first started getting on court.
Yep.
Because like you said, like I said, you know, you kind of can take it for granted, oh, I'll train, I'll play, I can go to play squash anytime, you know, things like that before all this virus. But obviously when something you love has been taken away from you, you just really appreciate what you could do before, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I definitely think that over the next few months, if I get back to playing, it would be obviously lovely. But then when things get better and then the competition and the training starts increasing, then you get into a different zone altogether.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So it's like, it's a little of a nice innocent space in the head right now with the game.
Mm.
But obviously, as you get back on tour or competing again, obviously the mindset changes a little bit, you know.
Okay, fine. Thanks a lot.